And here we have a campground for motorcycles. This particular trailer that's pulled behind a motorcycle turns into a big tent. And these folks are traveling in motorcycles and they're hauling trailers behind their motorcycles. See, so they're big motorcycles that are strong enough to pull the trailer. And there's two people riding the motorcycle and it's pulling a trailer.
He's packing it up, see?
Uh-huh. And here's a Honda 3-wheeler.
Oh, okay.
Isn't it beautiful? That's a 3-wheel. And they're all from the Idaho pole, right here.
Okay, you're there.
They're getting their trailers ready to take off. Okay, we're going to be talking to these interesting folk that are riding these motorcycles and traveling with trailers. And I asked them already if they're wanted by the FBI, and he says, what, the statute of limitations?
Statute of limitations got to be up by now.
It's got to be up by now. Okay, so, all right, so what's your name?
My name's Brad.
Brad, and the young lady?
My wife, Laura.
Laura.
Laura? Okay, Brad and Laura. Okay, and
Bradley.
And Bradley?
Bradley.
We have comments from the other section of the of the park that's pulling out, so they're going to say anything they want, because they're not going to be here in a few more minutes. Anyway, how long you been doing this or traveling this way?
Oh, last 5 years.
Okay, and normally you pull a trailer?
Pull a tent trailer right there.
Okay.
The green tent trailer.
Okay.
Pull it behind a motorcycle. Okay.
And you came all the way from Idaho?
Fruitland, Idaho.
Where?
Fruitland, Idaho.
Fruitland, Idaho. Okay, and do you travel mostly to the west or to the east?
Yeah, try to see where it's cool, so it'd be the west.
Okay. Okay. Now, we got some folks here that are almost going to take off on us right over there. What's your name?
My name's Greg.
Greg?
Yep, and that's my wife, Sandy, in the orange.
Okay, Sandy in the orange that likes the Broncos.
Yep.
Okay. He's a Bronco fan.
A Bronco fan. Since 1932, is this right there? Boise State?
Yes.
Okay, Boise State. That's in Idaho, I imagine.
Yep. Yep.
Okay, all right. Okay, and where are you guys going to go now?
We're going down south.
Towards San Jose.
San Jose?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then from San Jose, are you going to go more south or turn?
Well, we're not sure yet. Maybe a little bit more south and then probably head back home.
Because you're heading into hot weather.
Yes.
Real hot, because we came from there.
Yeah. Did ya?
So
yeah.
Probably won't go too far.
It's about 100 degrees in the daytime over there. Well, not San Jose, but inland toward the Santanella on the Interstate 5.
Right.
It's 100 in the daytime when we were there 3 days ago.
Yeah.
Well, we're either going to go down toward Big Sur, and then we might work our way over through Yosemite, and then probably up through Lake Tahoe, and then back toward Idaho. So, yeah, it'll be hot. So we're going to enjoy the cool weather while we have it.
Right. Okay. So you're going that way, and then they're going to stay over here, right?
You better ask him.
Oh, he's
let me introduce you to Randy, though. This is Randy,
I'm
and he's looking for a woman.
Count.
Randy's looking. Now, we live.
What's
in
your phone number, Randy?
Okay, for a good time, and any woman who wants to call Randy, we can give you his number offline here. He's looking for a good woman. Or any
money.
Woman. Or any woman.
Or
any,
yeah.
Yeah,
any
woman.
Right.
Okay, yeah, we saw the show. Okay, so what's your next move after this one?
We are heading down the coast. We're going to go to Bandon, Oregon.
Oh, so you're going north?
We're heading north, yeah.
Okay. Brandon?
Bandon.
Bandon. How far is that from here?
About
125
miles.
125 miles. Like
camp there, and then we'll go into Lyons, Oregon.
Lyons?
A little bit inland.
Oh, okay.
Go see some friends and then head home.
Oh, okay. So. Well, that's about, what, a 2,000-mile round trip?
Oh, no.
More?
Maybe, by the time trip and everything, maybe 1,200.
1,200-mile round trip?
Miles,
okay, great. Okay, I forgot to ask this gentleman's name.
I'm Andy.
Andy. Okay, and you're part of this crew?
I am. I'm the old guy in the bunch.
Oh, okay. Well, someone's got to be mature and wise.
Right. Whoa. You just said old guy. With no maturity or wise.
We're the ones that ride the tripod, as everybody calls it now. So.
That's his new nickname,
yeah,
tripod.
The tripod. Yeah, tripod. Okay, and that's a stable bike.
This guy is the one that has to have two wheels on the back so he don't fall over.
Well, I'm familiar with those.
Which we'll all have one eventually.
Here comes his wife.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
And down the road there.
Oh, wait, where's the wife?
Right there walking.
Wait, okay. It's got a telescopic thing so we can see her right there. Okay.
We won't get much out of her.
She's quite quiet, yes.
That's kind of unusual for a wife.
Oh, she talks a lot with the tents closed.
Okay. And what's her name?
Her name is Tish.
Sid?
No.
Tish.
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 If it's Sid, we're in trouble.
Okay. T-I-C-S-H. Like for Trisha. Okay. Yeah, we got her walking all the way over here. And
Smile, baby. You're on camera.
She wonders why she's on camera.
We don't know either.
Okay, very good.
Channel 7 News.
So is there anything you'd like to say to wrap this up?
No, I mean, enjoy it. It's a lot of fun. If you have the youth and the time and the money, do it.
You only live once.
That's right.
You only live once.
Only live once.
I'm still single.
Yeah, he's going to stay that way.
So do you have an internet address that women can reach you at?
I'm in a semi-truck all the time, so I'm... Address USA.
Yes. So if you see a man looking like him,
run!
The advice from his friends are to hide. Okay. Okay, now he's going to tell us all about his three-wheeler here. Okay, so tell me about it. Now, what is it? Is this original or what?
No, the 1800 is a Goldwing, and then the conversion to convert it over is by California Sidecar.
Okay, so the motorcycle was not purchased this way originally at
right.
the factory.
It was originally just a motorcycle.
Oh, just a motorcycle, right. And then you converted it over?
To the trike, yes.
Okay.
And everything from this seat down on the back here, this is all, this whole back end is all aftermarket.
Okay.
This part of the bike up here, from right here forward, is all bike. The saddlebag here on the back, the trunk, that was part of the motorcycle. And everything from there down is all
okay.
aftermarket.
And you're saying something about the suspension?
Suspension is, it's all independent suspension. It also has adjustable. We still use the same suspension that the motorcycle had. It's got memory settings. You can raise suspension, stiffen it up, or soften it up.
Okay, adjustable suspension.
Yeah, just suspension.
Wow.
So, yeah,
it's a luxury.
It has ABS brakes.
Wow.
It's air-cooled, six-cylinder motor.
Wow.
Or not air-cooled, but water-cooled.
Water-cooled, six-cylinder motor.
Adjustable headlight. You can adjust your headlight up and down as you go up and down the road by turning the dial.
Wow.
You can set your memory on your settings for suspension, yeah. So if you're riding by yourself, you can hit memory setting one. If you're riding with your wife, you can hit memory setting two. And adjust the suspension.
Wow.
It's got a navigation screen for your navigation.
Got everything.
Stereo, CB radio, mic for your CB, your antenna for your CB.
Okay, so CB radios, antennas right here. Okay.
Yeah, it's got cruise control.
Wow.
Heated grips, heated seats.
Wow. Just a fancy, beautiful bike.
Yeah, they're kind of cool.
Yeah, they're neat. And
we pull this trailer with it.
And you pull this trailer. Okay, so we're going to look at the trailer here. And this is the trailer hitch right here.
Yeah.
Here's the front of the trailer. And then it converts into a big old tent.
Has a king-size bed.
King-size bed inside, huh?
And a 5x6 dressing room.
Wow. You never would believe that comes out of that little trailer.
Yeah, when it's all folded up, it looks just like kids right there.
Okay, and then when it's all folded up, we're going to see what it looks like. It looks just like that.
In fact, his is identical to ours, except a different color on the inside.
Okay. And about how much does that weigh?
Empty, they're about 350 pounds.
Okay.
And of course, when you load them up.
350, and then you put stuff in there, right?
Yeah. We get about, ours is about 600 time we get it all loaded.
600 pounds, okay. Wow, fantastic. What a way to travel.
Fun, kind of fun way to go.
Yeah, it's kind of fun. Super, super fun. Everybody wants to do that before they grow up.
Well, you know, we've had... motorhomes and fifth wheels and travel trailers.
Yeah, this is fun.
this sold out. We're kind of going backwards, but I mean, we're enjoying this.
Yeah, of course. It's fun. You got to enjoy your life. Yeah, do whatever you we can do what we can.
Exactly. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, they're fun. It's a real kick, especially when you get to go with the group and everybody's got 10 trailers.
Yeah.
We'll take off.
Very good.
Take off. Still pretty economical way to travel. Yeah, get pull on them about 30 miles a gallon.
You can't beat that.
You can't beat that with your motorhome or your fifth wheel.
Never. What's that?
Right. Okay. Yeah, they're pretty neat.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Okay, they're leaving now. Thank you.